So in this video, we learn about the velocity time graph of different type of motions. First one is the velocity time graph for uniform motion, or you can say the velocity time graph for the constant velocity. See, this is the velocity time graph. This is your y-axis, this is your y-axis, and this is the x-axis. So normally, what I told you, x-axis will be your time axis, and y-axis have taken as the velocity. Okay, so see, in this graph the velocity is not at all changing as the time is increasing. So this is 1 hour, this is 2 hour, 3 hour, 4 hour, and the velocity is remain fixed. The time is in hour, velocity is in remain constant. So that is why it is a constant velocity. So now, if the velocity is constant, then what you can say from here, what you can conclude from here, velocity is constant, v is equal to constant, and so we can say acceleration is not there. So acceleration is zero. That is that you can say. See, similar type of graph we learned previous class, that was on distance time graph. In this graph you see that again this is a parallel to the time axis. So difference was, this is the graph of the object which is at rest. If the object which is at rest, then what will be the velocity? The velocity will be zero. If the velocity is zero, naturally there will be no acceleration. So acceleration is also zero. So sometimes question comes, draw the distance time graph for the object which is having zero acceleration. So you have to draw this. If the question comes, draw the velocity time graph for the acceleration is zero, then you can draw this one, this graph. Okay, then we'll go to next thing, that is called the velocity time graph for uniformly accelerated motion. So what we can learn from the velocity time graph? First you have to know this. So we can find out the velocity of the object in different time. So this is 1 hour, we can find out the velocity here. 2 hours, we can find out the velocity here. In 3 hours, we can find out the velocity here. So see, in each and every time the velocity is increasing gradually. Okay, that is why the velocity is increasing in a constant rate. So that is why it is definitely an accelerated motion. And what you can find out from the velocity time graph is, if we can find the slope. Slope means what? Slope means perpendicular by base. You have to do this upon this. Okay, so this one is velocity, this one is time. So slope is equal to here's a BD by OD. So you get BD is equal to V and OD is equal to T. So what is V by T? V by T is acceleration. So in this graph, each and every point, even if I find out the slope for this triangle also, so we'll get the constant acceleration. Okay, so here the acceleration is constant. That is why it is called uniform acceleration. So A is constant. And velocity is uniform. Velocity is increasing gradually. Okay, so we know that adding or increasing of velocity is known as the acceleration. So here is a constant acceleration. So where you can see this type of graph? For example, if I drop a object, if I'm having a ball in my hand, and if I drop the ball towards the ground, okay, the ball is going towards the ground with a constant acceleration. Constant acceleration is g. That is called the acceleration due to gravity. Already I told this. Okay, so as the ball is going towards the ground, acceleration is increasing in a constant rate. So we'll get this graph. So initially ball was in your hand, the velocity was zero, and ball is as you release the ball from your hand, the then ball is going towards the ground, the velocity is increasing. So this is this type of graph. Next one will come to uniform deceleration or retarded motion. See, here the velocity, it is having some velocity, and as the time is increasing, you can observe as the time is increasing, the velocity is decreasing in a constant rate. So that is the uniform decelerated motion. Even this example is, if I throw a ball towards the sky in a straight line, if I throw a ball towards the sky in a straight line, so what you see, initially the ball is having a huge amount of velocity, suppose say 20 meter per second velocity was there. Okay, as the ball is going up, the velocity is decreasing, and on the top the velocity will be zero. So what you can say, the velocity is decreasing. As the velocity is decreasing, so this is a retarded motion, uniform retarded motion. So here g minus g is working here. So this type of graph you will get. Velocity was more and gradually it is decreasing, and at the end the velocity will become zero. So in this point the velocity will become zero. So this will get this type of graph. Next one is the velocity time graph for non-uniform velocity. So here, suppose in this case, what is happening? The velocity is decreasing. Here the velocity is increasing and decreasing and increasing. Like this way, we can say this is the non-uniform. Okay. So another type of graph will come here. So velocity time graph for non-uniform acceleration. See, in this case, this type of graph we got. Why it is called non-uniform acceleration? Because each and every point, if I find out the slope here, so you'll get here, you will get different slope, here we'll get different slope. So in this case, the slope is different in each and every point. So what we can find out, if I find out the slope of velocity time graph, you will get acceleration. But the acceleration is changing. What you can see here, acceleration is increasing. As the acceleration is increasing, then we can say this is non-uniform accelerated motion. Okay, so see, in this graph, this is also a velocity time graph. Another example, so two objects are there which are moving in a velocity time graph, they have plotted. So which one is having more acceleration? Whether B is having more acceleration or A is having more acceleration? So first you have to know which one is having the whose slope is more. So see, in this case, the slope of the B and slope of the A, then you can find out whose slope is more. So slope of the B is more. Slope of the B is more than the slope of the A. Okay. So the slope of the velocity time graph B is greater than the slope for the A. Thus, the acceleration of B is greater than that of the A. So these things we can learn. And another thing also we can learn from the velocity time graph. So that is called a displacement. You can find out the displacement from the velocity time graph. If it is a speed time graph, then you can find out the distance. So here, how to find out the displacement? So suppose you will draw a line like this, and here also. So this is the time of 1 hour distance. 1 hour gap is there, and the velocity is remain constant. Now if you find out the area under this graph, then what will get? So naturally you can say this is velocity, because this length and this length are same, and this is time. So in this case, if you find out the area of this particular portion, then what you can say, area is equal to length into breadth, that means V into T. So what is V into T? V into T means S. Why? Because V is equal to what? S by T. So do cross multiplication, we get what? S is equal to VT. This is the formula. Then from the velocity time graph, we can also find out the displacement. Here also same thing. If I find out the displacement, then you have to find out the area of this trapezium. Or we can find out the area of this triangle and the area of this portion, then we can add, then we can get the velocity, displacement from this velocity time graph. Okay. So, on brief, I want to tell you what you can learn from the velocity time graph. We can find out so many things. First one is, we can find out the velocity in different positions, then we can find out the acceleration, and then we can find out the area. And with that area, we can find out the displacement using the velocity time graph. So thank you very much.